अस्सलामु अलैकुम क्लास, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस एंड लर्न अबाउट ओस्मो रेगुलेशन इन फिशेस। नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रोसेस ऑफ ओस्मो रेगुलेशन इन फिशेस। ओस्मो रेगुलेशन इज डिफाइंड एज द मेंटेनेंस ऑफ वाटर एंड सॉल्ट बैलेंस इन द बॉडी और द कंट्रोल ऑफ ओस्मोसिस। Fishes must maintain a proper balance of electrolytes and water in their tissues for their survival. The osmoregulation is a major function of the kidneys and gills of fishes. Kidneys are located near the midline of the body. These are present dorsal to peritoneal membrane. This peritoneal membrane lines the body cavity of the fishes. The excretory structures in the kidney are called nephrons, which are the functional unit of the kidney. Nephrons filter nitrogenous waste, ions, water and small organic compounds through glomeruli. The filtrate then passes through a tubule system. These tubules can reabsorb essential components and the remaining filtrate in the tubule system is then excreted out. Now there is a term in this slide that is fresh water. Fresh water is any water having salt concentration of less than 1%, and we will discuss about the adaptations of freshwater fishes for osmoregulation. And the fresh water is any naturally occurring water except sea water and brackish water, and this water includes ice sheets, ice caps, glaciers, icebergs, bogs, ponds, lakes, rivers, streams and even underground water. Fresh water is generally characterized by having low concentration of dissolved salts and other total dissolved solids. The osmoregulatory mechanism in freshwater fishes is discussed here in some points, like the freshwater fishes never drink water to control excess water and ions loss. They take water only during feeding. Their nephrons have large glomeruli and short tubular system. They also get some salts through their food. The large glomeruli and short tubular systems helps in reabsorption of some ions and organic compounds after filtration. And their nephrons have short tubular system, therefore little water is reabsorbed, because tubules of the glomeruli or tubules of the nephron reabsorb the water. If a fish have small sized tubules, therefore these fishes do not reabsorb much of the water, and fishes produce a very large quantity of dilute urine. Ions can be lost through the urine. These fishes also lost ions by diffusion across gill and oral surfaces. Therefore, the gills of these fishes can absorb ions by active transport. It compensates this ion loss. Freshwater fishes also get some salts through their food. Perhaps 90% of all bony fishes are restricted to either a freshwater or seawater habitat because they are incapable of osmotic regulation. In the wrong habitat, most freshwater fishes quickly die if placed in seawater, as do marine fishes placed in freshwater. Freshwater fishes are hyperosmotic regulators because they can remove or pump out the excess water out by opisthonephric kidneys, which are capable of forming very dilute urine. Second, special salt absorbing cells located in the gill epithelium actively move salt ions, principally sodium and chloride, from water to the blood. This absorption, together with salt present in the fish's food, replaces diffusive salt loss. These mechanisms are so efficient that a freshwater fish spends only a small part of its total energy maintaining itself in osmotic balance. Now the question arises, why the freshwater fishes produce large quantity of very dilute urine? Because their nephrons have short tubular system, therefore little water is reabsorbed and their ions can be lost through urine. So the gills of fishes can absorb ions by active transport, and freshwater fishes also get some salts through their food. Now we are going to discuss about osmoregulatory mechanism in marine fishes. Marine fishes face opposite problem because the environment of marine fishes contains 3.5% ions, but the tissues of marine fishes have only 0.65% ions. Therefore, they face the problem of water loss and accumulation of excess ions. So they have different adaptations to compensate the loss of water, and these adaptations include drinking of water to compensate the loss of water, as well as they eliminate excess ions by excretion, defecation and active transport through their gills. The nephrons of marine fishes possess small glomeruli and long tubule systems. Therefore, less blood is filtered than freshwater fishes, and water is efficiently reabsorbed from the nephron. Marine bony fishes are hypoosmotic regulators that encounter a complex different phenomena. They have a much lower blood salt concentration than seawater, and therefore they lose water and gain salt. A marine teleost fish quite literally risk drying out, much like a desert mammal deprived of water. To compensate for water loss, a marine teleost drinks seawater. Excess salt accompanying the seawater is disposed of in multiple ways. Major sea salt ions like sodium chloride and potassium are carried by the blood to the gills, where they are secreted outward by special salt secretory cells. The remaining sea salt ions, mostly magnesium sulfate and calcium, are voided with feces or excreted by the kidneys. Unlike a freshwater fish, kidneys, which form urine by usual filtration resorption sequence typical of most vertebrate kidneys, a marine fish's kidneys excrete divalent ions by tubular secretion. Because very little, if any, filtrate is formed, the glomeruli have lost their importance and disappeared in some marine teleosts. Pipe fishes and frog fishes are examples of aglomerular marine fishes. Diagram showing the osmoregulatory mechanism in freshwater fishes. Like I already have told you in the last slide, that the freshwater fishes never drink water to control excess water and ion loss. They take water in only during feeding, and their nephrons of freshwater fishes possess large glomeruli, as you can see here in the diagram, that they have large glomeruli and a short tubular system. Because if the tubule system will be a larger one, then there will be more reabsorption of ions. But these fishes have short tubule system, therefore reabsorption of some ions and organic compounds take place after filtration, but their nephrons have short tubule system, and this short tubule results in little water reabsorption. Therefore, freshwater fishes produce a very large quantity of dilute urine. Their ions can also be lost through their gills, as these gills are shown in the diagram. So, to prevent this, these fishes have different mechanisms. Like the gills of these fishes can reabsorb ions by active transport. And these fishes compensate this ion loss by this active mechanism, and freshwater fishes also get some salts through their food, so they can maintain a reasonable salt or solute concentration in their body by this mechanism. As I already have told you that marine fishes are hypoosmotic regulators, therefore they drink water to compensate the loss of water. They excrete excess ions by excretion, defecation and active transport through their gills. Because their environment have abundance of these ions, so they have to actively transport these ions across their gills. Now the question arises, why marine fishes produce a very low amount of urine? And the answer of this question is that these fishes have small glomeruli in their nephrons, and glomeruli, as you know, that these are the ball of capillaries in the nephrons, and they have very long tubular system. Therefore, less blood is filtered in marine fishes because there is a small glomeruli than that of freshwater fishes, and water is efficiently reabsorbed from the nephrons. Why water is efficiently reabsorbed from the nephrons? Because these fishes have long tubular system which can efficiently reabsorb the water from these tubules. In this slide you can see that a freshwater fish maintains osmotic and ion balance in its dilute environment by actively absorbing sodium chloride across the gills. Some salt is gained with food to flush out excess water that constantly enters the body. The glomerular kidney produces a dilute urine by reabsorbing sodium chloride. A marine fish must drink sea water to replace water loss osmotically to its salty environment. Sodium chloride and water are absorbed from the stomach. Excess sodium chloride is actively transported outward by the gills. Divalent sea salts, mostly magnesium sulfate, are eliminated with feces and secreted by the tubular kidney. Since the salt content in the blood of marine fishes is much lower than that of sea water, they constantly tend to lose water and build up salt. To replace the water loss, they continually need to drink seawater. Since their small kidney can only excrete relatively small amount of urine, the excretion of salt additionally takes place in the gills, where chloride cells work in reverse as in freshwater fishes. You can clearly see in this diagram that the gain of water and salt ions from food, the gain of water and salt ions from the drinking seawater, and these fishes excrete salt ions from their gills, as well as they excrete salt ions and small amounts of water in scanty urine from their kidneys. In this last slide, there is a comparison between freshwater and marine teleost. As I already have told you that the freshwater fishes never drink water, as you can see in this diagram that they only eat food, they do not drink water. To control excess water and ions, they take water only during feeding process. The nephrons of freshwater fishes also possess large glomeruli and short tubular systems. Therefore, reabsorption of some ions and organic compounds takes place after filtration process. Similarly, they have little water reabsorptions because their nephrons have short tubular system. In this way, the freshwater fishes produce large quantity of very dilute urine. Their ions can be lost through the urine. These also lost by diffusion across gill and oral surfaces. Therefore, the gills of these fishes can absorb ions by active transport. It compensates this loss of ions, and freshwater fishes also get some salts through their food. While the marine fishes face the opposite problems, like they drink water to compensate the loss of water, they eliminate excess ions by excretion, defecation and active transport through their gills, as is shown in the diagram. The nephrons of marine fishes possess small glomeruli and long tubular systems. Therefore, less blood is filtered in these fishes, and water is efficiently reabsorbed from the nephrons of these fishes, and these produce very small volume of concentrated urine
while the freshwater fishes produce dilute urine or a very huge amount of urine.